Hi, and welcome to Inverting and Non-Inverting Operational Amplifiers. In this video, we will be focusing on operational amplifiers and how to solve for voltages, currents, and resistances. We will specifically be covering inverting and non-inverting amplifiers. Inverting amplifiers have negative gain because the voltage input is to the inverting input. The circuit shown here is a basic example that we can easily follow to see how the gain is negative. As we've discussed, the voltage inputs are the same in an ideal op-amp. Since the non-inverting input is connected to ground, the voltage is zero. Also noted is that there is no current in the op-amp, so therefore the current in, denoted II, and the current in the feedback loop, IF, are the same. By doing nodal analysis, we can see that at the inverting input, the difference between VIN and VI negative over RI gives II. We can then look at the difference between VI negative and Vout over RF to find IF. Setting these equations equal to each other and multiplying both sides by negative RF, we can get Vout equals negative RF divided by RI times VN. As you can see, the negative RF divided by RI value is the gain and is thus inverting. I'll now show you the more general version. Inverting circuits are represented by any combination of circuit elements to create impedances ZI and ZF. The transfer function dependent on frequency is Vout divided by VN equals negative impedance F divided by impedance I. Non-inverting amplifiers have a positive gain because the input voltage is connected to the non-inverting input. In this example, VN is directly connected to the non-inverting amplifier, so it is equal to VI negative, which is equal to VI plus. We also know that there is no current into the op-amp. For this reason, I1 is then equal to I2. Solving for the current I1, we can look at the nodal branch between Vout and VI negative. Vout minus VI negative divided by R1 gives I1. Since VI negative is equal to VN, we can substitute VN into the equation. Solving for the bottom branch, we take VI minus ground divided by R2. This yields VI negative divided by R2, which is equal to VN divided by R2 using substitution. We can then set the currents equal to each other. Rearranging, we multiply each side by R2. We then move VN components to one side. Finally, we multiply by R1 divided by R2 to both sides. The result is Vout equals VN times R1 divided by R2 plus 1. Again, I'll show you the more general circuit. Non-inverting circuits are represented by any combination of circuit elements to create impedances 1 and 2. The transfer function, as a function of frequency, is Vout divided by VN equals 1 plus impedance 2 divided by impedance 1. That's all for now, but I hope this has helped.